It's been a while since we have visited the Nullah. And it's the first time that we could get a better look at Kaylee's left hand. Remember those two swollen fingers that she had a few months back? They were in bad shape. So what has become of them now? The parts bearing the nails had largely been reabsorbed and whatever were left have since collapsed and telescoped onto themselves, leaving her with two shorter but stubbier fingers there. Functionally, her left hand is affected, so it seems. She's one lucky girl. But then they always seem to heal such soft tissue injuries amazingly well. A case in point is Pucky. Just look at his face and hand. You don't need to put them in a cage to heal such injuries. Poor Kailey, she had her beans. But I think we all know what Harlow's experiment have shown us. These babies need more than just a full stomach. Pucky could always find her mum nearby. as could Dipsy. And he could rely on his mum to come to his aid every time. But not Kailey. The saving grace is she has learnt to look after herself a lot earlier on than her peers. She is better than others at taking nectar from those camellias. Poor lil Kailey. Someone has asked me whether Kailey is bigger than Teeny from Skullhead's troop. My answer is that Kailey is normal-sized, albeit a bit skinnier than her peers. But poor Teeny just hasn't grown much at all from her newborn size. She is just half the size of what a four-month-old should be. Is that Gypsy there? I think it is her. You could tell she doesn't want her to be around. And Kailey has clearly got her message. That's another no again. Unlike Dipsy, she isn't going to get any help from Gypsy. She has to find a way up by herself. Back to Gypsy again. She's still drawn to her no matter how Gypsy treats her.